Hey guys, my name is Richard Liu, and for those of you that are new to my channel, I am a hyper-realistic artist. So I get a lot of questions on the materials that I use, and as we all know, materials are very important for an artist's success because it's what we use every day to create our works. So in this video, I'm going to show you all the different tools that I use, whether it's the type of paper, the drawing material, the blending material, or what I use to erase and other accessories that you might not know. Keep in mind that I will have a link on Amazon to purchase in the description below, so you can find that easily and purchase it easily as well to support my channel. So starting with the type of paper. For my current work, I'm using Arches Watercolor Hot Press 300 grams. Before this, I've only used Stonehenge paper, which was the paper that my art teacher in high school introduced me to, and I've basically only used that for the last 4 years. Stonehenge is definitely a good quality paper that is levels above the normal sketching paper or A4 paper that beginners use to learn to draw, and it's quite affordable too. In the past few months, I've been asking other artists on what they use for their drawings, and the most common answer that I got was actually Arches Watercolor Hot Press 300 grams, the one that I'm currently using. But of course, there's a major downside to it, which is the price tag, which might be quite obvious because of the quality that it provides. But depending on where your works are at and what stage of your career you're in, you can definitely see if you want to commit to that investment. Also, keep in mind that this will make it more appealing to the buyers and collectors of art because they will know that it's better quality paper and that it will last. So it can often sell out for more. Pencils are the one thing I'm not lacking and don't constantly have to buy. For the graphite pencils I currently use, I'm using the Staedtler brand, which is this, a blue one. And I haven't experimented around too much with pencil brands, but different brands definitely offer different varieties, like how easily it is to erase or how easily it is to apply to the paper, and even the darkness of the tone is varied. So for my charcoal, I use Generals and this woodless charcoal pencil that I got from Hobby Lobby mainly because of the aesthetics and how thin it was. Some of the newer artists might be wondering what the difference between charcoal and graphite is, and it mainly comes down to details, reflection, and the darkness. It is a lot more difficult to create little details with charcoal the same way that you can do with a graphite, but at the same time, charcoal offers very rich and dark tones that graphite just cannot get. So for graphite to create very dark tones, you need to press really hard with a 6B or a 9B, but when you do that, it creates a large area which reflects light depending on where you look at it, and sometimes that can be really nasty, especially if it's the background. But charcoal definitely gets rid of that. So if you're doing like a background or a small piece that's solid black, I definitely recommend the charcoal. And the white charcoal definitely comes in very handy for when I need to bring out highlights in areas. Lastly, for drawing materials, I have the mechanical pencil. The advantage of a mechanical pencil is that you don't constantly have to sharpen it, of course, and the lead is very, very thin, so that means I can get a lot of little details. It's definitely a big time saver, and I use it a lot when I want to get little meticulous detail. Moving on to erasing materials, there are three objects that I use that I highly recommend. The first one is obviously the common pink eraser. I find this to be one of the best options because it does its job very well and it doesn't leave any nasty marks. I use this tool for large areas and backgrounds and to clean up my edges. The Faber-Castell kneaded eraser is a tool that took me a little while to learn, but after I got the hang of it, it is something that I just cannot live without. So there are many ways to use this tool. One of it is to pinch it and morph it into a small fine point and erase any different shapes that you might have. Another way of using this is almost like a normal eraser, but it doesn't necessarily work the same way because it pulls away layers of it instead of the whole graphite or charcoal, whichever one you're using. So you can almost use it to lighten very large areas. There's actually many other methods of using the kneaded eraser that I just cannot cover in this video. So if you're curious about it, feel free to leave a comment and I will make a longer video showing you the different techniques of it and demonstrate how or when to use it. Lastly, for smaller areas, I use the Mono Zero mechanical eraser. I got this tool online for about $5, and it is definitely very, very useful. I think this tool elevated my drawing of textures and especially skin because it saves so much time and it is extremely versatile. I highly recommend every artist to have this tool, especially if you're drawing people or portraits. Again, I'm gonna have a link in the description below. For blending tools, I created this video a while ago comparing the different methods artists use to create smudges. My most frequently used is the blending stump and the makeup brush. I used to use my fingers a lot, but I know some professional artists that still use it. So it's definitely up to your preference. But now I've replaced that with blending stumps. It could be used in almost every situation, as well as creating some interesting textures. Whereas the makeup brush usually works best when it comes to graphite or charcoal powder, it creates this really soft and beautiful transition that other tools just simply cannot get. Finally, for some other accessories and tools, I use the X-Acto knife for sharpening my pencils. I previously made an entire video on why or how to sharpen your pencils with knives instead of a pencil sharpener, so if you're interested in that, check that out. This pencil extension tool allows me to keep using my pencils even when they get worn out and short by just attaching it to the end of the pencil so you don't really let any of the pencil go to waste. I learned this method from Jono Dry, so if you're interested, definitely check out his channel. He's an amazing artist that I learned a lot from. Lastly, fixative, which helps seal the works and it prevents smudges on the final finished product. So here you go, there are the tools that I use for my drawings. If there are any questions that you would like to ask or if you thought I forgot something, feel free to leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe. As always, thank you for the support and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.